Hello, welcome viewers to Elimu TV, whereby we are going to learn and experience together. Today we are going to have Biology Form 1, Lesson 4, whereby your tutor will be Mr. Gerard. We are going to handle the topic on transport in plants under the subtopic transpiration. We must first know what transpiration is before we go deeper into the topic, subtopic, but before that, you can have the following lesson goal, whereby by the end of the lesson, you should be able to identify three types of transpiration in plants. So let us now define what transpiration is, and we can say that transpiration is a process by which through which plants lose water in form of water vapor to the atmosphere. We have got around three forms of transpiration, whereby, as you can see from the screen, the first type of transpiration that we're going to handle is the stomato transpiration. In the stomato transpiration, this is the loss of water vapor through the stomata. It accounts for 80 to 90% of water transpiration in plants. Most stomata are found on the leaves, but may also occur on the epidermis of young herbaceous stems. So generally, we are saying that the stomato's transpiration is the loss of water vapor to the atmosphere through the stomatas. And as you can see, in the stomatas is whereby you are finding the gall cells, whereby the gall cells they are able to open and close to allow either the opening and closing of the stomata. So the water vapor is when it lands on the stomatas, which are found on the upper epidermis, they are able to be to evaporate to the atmosphere. As you are seeing from the diagram, whereby we have the gall cell, the mesophyll cell, these ones they are all embedding the stoma. That is the singular for the stomata. So the second transpiration, we are having the cuticular transpiration, whereby, as you can see from our diagram, this is in simple terms, cuticular transpiration is the loss of water from the plants in form of water vapor through the cuticles of plants. So as you can see from the left side, we have evaporation, whereby the water in the soils they change to gas, or the as the ground surfaces warms up. This water is being absorbed from the soil, and it is being transported through the xylem vessels of the stem, whereby they reach also the xylem vessels of the leaves, and they eventually leave the cuticles of the leaves, and they are evaporated to the atmosphere. This is what we are calling the cuticular transpiration. So we can say this is the loss of water in the form of water vapor through the cuticle. Up to 20% of total transpiration may take place through the cuticle. In plants with thick cuticles, the loss is negligible. Remember, in the stomato transpiration, we have said that 80 to 90% of water is lost through the stomata. And now, in this cuticular transpiration, we are saying that only about 20%. So, as we compare the transpiration through the stomatas and the cuticles, it means that the transpiration through the stomatas is more compared to the cuticles. We have also our third type of transpiration, whereby it is called the lenticular transpiration. As you can see from our diagram, we have the secondary cortex, that is from the background. We have the secondary cortex, which we have also the cork cambium. We have the cork itself. Now we have the epidermis and the columbar cell, whereby these ones are giving rise to the lenticular cells. So in simple terms, we can say the lenticular transpiration is the loss of water vapor through the lenticels. So we can say this is the loss of water in plants as water vapor through the lenticels. Remember, these lenticels, they are loosely packed cells on woody plants. But the loss of water vapor through the lenticels is negligible. It will be difficult for you to recognize the transpiration through the lenticels. Remember that these lenticels, they are normally found in the leaves. So, as water vaporizes from the spongy mesophyll cells into the substomato air spaces, their cells become more concentrated than the adjacent cells. This increases the osmotic pressure of responsive mesophyll cells. As a result, water flows into these cells from other surrounding cells, which in turn take in water from blood vessels within the leaf veins. So you therefore notice that the water lost through the leaf comes into the leaf through the xylem in the leaf, which is in a continuous connection with the xylem of the stem and that of the root. It is therefore also necessary that you study the structure of the xylem and also the root. So those are the three types of transpiration, whereby we have said the first one is the stomatal transpiration, the second one is the cuticular transpiration, and the third one we have said is the lenticular transpiration. But remember, you have said that the main form of transpiration is through the stomatus, which is the stomatal transpiration. Having done and said that, we can have the following activity, whereby you are required to give three types of transpiration. For more reference or more information on this lesson, you can refer to Secondary Biology Students Book 1, Kenya Literature Bureau. And for this and more information, you can contact us by sending us an SMS on the number that is appearing on our screen, or you subscribe to our YouTube channel, which is Elimu TV, or you send us a message on our Facebook page, which is also Elimu TV, or you subscribe to our Twitter page, which is at Elimu TV _ Kenya. Thank you for watching, and let us subscribe to the channels that you are seeing on our screen, such that we get this and more of our lessons. Thank you.